feel right. Blood, sweat, and tears just to live life. Talk to God even when I didn't see light. Still talk to him when it got bright. Dark days were made for the spotlight. We paid, now mama can sleep tight. The champions, the champions. Hey, we gon' bow, never fall. The champions, the champions, the champions. Hey, we gon' bow, never fall. I put my head up and told them crown me. My ring finger got a rock on it, rock on it. I put my head up and told them crown me. My ring finger got a rock on it, rock on it, rock on it.
Ready to fight? Ready. Let's do it.
Well, for all the places we go in the world, few can hold up to this one. Good evening from T-Mobile Arena here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Opened April of 2016. UFC went there for the first time at UFC 200, and they've been bringing big shows seemingly every other month ever since.
They called Vegas the fight capital of the world.
Now he's masterful from here.
Oh, he went.
Oh!
Oh, what a fantastic takedown. Look at that. Recognize he's about to lose position.
Drops down inside the now closed guard of his opponent.
Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big ground and pound.
All right, side control now. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire.
Big ground and pound.
Guillotine attempt now. Looks as though he's got the neck. That guillotine is tight.
Great submission defense.
And he's back up. Collar tie here in the clinch.
Oh, he did a great job of rotating him into an underhook. Oh, he's got a guillotine here. Oh.
Oh, that killie is tight. Also, how about that position over submission as he bails on the sub?
I think that's a great job. You've got to make sure you don't end up in a worse position because you're trying to score submission.
Arm triangle attempt here.
Nice arm triangle setup.
Ooh, arm triangle's in tight.
It's getting in very tight. That is great submission defense, keeping everything short and not allowing his opponent to get the submission victory. He closes the distance beautifully. He's got a single collar tie.
Oh, now gets an underhook to get a more dominant position.
He's attacking guillotine. Oh!
Oh, got to protect your neck. Guillotine choke is locked in. Oh, he's out! Now drops inside that closed guard, DC.
Full guard. Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big ground and pound. What a tight arm bar.
Oh, that's tight as he transitions to the belly down arm bar. Oh, he's out.
Notice how his opponent circled back off to his right. Back towards the side that his opponent was on, got his hips all the way across to release the pressure off of his arm. Beautiful submission defense.
Ground and pound strike there now. 5 minutes in the books.
That's what I'm talking about right there. You can't handle
me. All right, let's look back at some of the action, DC. Your good friend Mark Coleman, the godfather of the ground and pound, would be proud.
He'd be very proud. He'd be very proud with the way that he showed his ability to use his ground and pound. He didn't waste any action. He did everything he needed to do. He was able to posture. He was able to control wrist. He did everything perfectly in his approach in that ground and pound sequence.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Checking out on the way.
Oh,
there's that jab. Oh, he's got the single collar locked in the clinch now.
Good punch, man.
Nice head kick gets through.
Good kick.
Changes levels. Oh!
Takedown.
Oh, some big elbows starting to pile up. Good series of elbows by him there. It's almost like he's ambidextrous when it comes to throwing these elbows.
There is no strike in fighting that can really damage your opponent as much as an elbow. He understands that. He's throwing them over and over again.
Well, that swelling, folks, is not from sodium. That is from a serious ground and pound attack from his opponent. Oh, nice ground and pound elbow to the dome. Oh, lands with that elbow again. Gets the elbow up into the target. And big elbows land flush.
Lands a nice punch from his back.
Well, you know he's tougher than I am, right? But this man has absorbed so much damage upstairs that I wouldn't be surprised to see the referee call in the doctor at some point.
At some point, you got to take a look at it. He's so bruised. He's so battered. He's so swollen. And credit to his opponent for finding a route to victory and staying on that. He has dominated this fight. Massive target on the side of his face with all that swelling. And his opponent smartly continues to attack it. It looks like the referee is going to call in the position to take a look.
Side control now. There's that knee to the body. Oh, a strong series of committed elbows here. Those are starting to add up. And busy as he looks to improve position here.
He's doing a really good job putting himself in position. Nice shots landing from the top position.
Oh, nice job to split his guard and get the ground strike home again.
He's gonna start trying to move to a submission here. It looks like he's trying to attack the arm triangle.
Oh, he might be in trouble here. Oh, somehow he gets out. Fantastic submission, D. Well, not good body language from his opponent here, DC. He's curled up.
No, he's exhausted, he's been beaten. Go.
10 minutes in the books. All right, there's the end of the round, and the end swell can only do so much, right? His face looks like it has been injected. It's so swollen. This fight could end at any moment. Hashtag. All right, as they attend to the damaged fighter, we will...
You ready to fight? You ready? Let's do it.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight.
That's a big strike right there.
Blistering combination there, really starting to do a nice job stringing the shots together.
And you can see the damage in his opponent's body, his face.
Oh,
takes him to a body, slams him on his back. What a takedown.
How's that feel to be in the
hand of that? I mean, this guy is really focused on those punches to the head inside of the clinch.
Job by him defensively there. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. Now we'll see if he has any response here. His opponent continues to land a lot of swell.
This is a terrible position.
Motioning for his opponent to stand back up here.
Nice, low single takedown.
Oh, nasty. nasty elbows now, DC. Hard to see if a cut's been opened up, but got to think at some point there's going to be some blood.
You got to be so close to Darce. Yep, he's trying to hit a Darce here.
That Darce choke is tight. Oh, looks like he might get the finish here.
This has to be it, John.
Fumamos dos o tres, bailamos la CRG, let's go, a CRG, ja, dejé, ella se dejó y yo me la llevé, hacemos el boogie, hacemos el wiggity-dee, ella lo pidió y yo sin miedo se lo di, let's go, I got shooting stars on my teeth, Nikes on my feet, make my cypher complete, cause I'm nice like that, baby I'm cool like that, dice mi coque rico que como yo no hay nada, ya estamos a 30 mil por party, salí pique tua, hoy salí de Bulgari, salió par de trago y se puso Bulgari, se vistió de chita, yo que vine de safari, Now you know what's up, aquí no hay excusa, súbete la falda, me gusta esa blusa, Now you know what's up, llegué y siempre abusa, sé que andas en alta de dos o tres la musa, mucha mami, en el club, baby, muévelo al revés. Cual yo quiero, yo no sé. Subo y bajalo otra vez. Que estoy con el crew y nos fumamos todos tres. Pero yo me la cereje. Ella se dejó y yo me la llevé. Hacemos el boogie, hacemos el wigiriri.
Ready, fight? Ready.
Out of the favelas and into your living room, and now one of the all-time great UFC lightweight champions, Charles Oliveira, first defended his title against Dustin Poirier. They run it back tonight. We'll see if your fellow Louisianan can make the adjustments.
It looked like Poirier had him out of there on a number of occasions in fight number one and in round number one. But in typical Charles Oliveira fashion, he continued to march forward until he finally got him where he wanted to, and he strangled him on his back with a rear naked choke. This Charles Oliveira, every time I leave the arena, I ask myself how. He's that good, and he's that fun to watch. I cannot wait to watch these two compete again. Oh, nice.
All right, so a nice job by the jiu-jitsu player to get the clinch situation here early. He was worried about those long-range weapons. Kind of hard to kick somebody when you're engaging in the clinch.
Yeah, but the clinch is where he needs to be. He needs to be in close, he needs to be tight, so that not only he can get takedowns, but he limits the things coming back in his direction.
All right, so another good series of knees by him there, DC. That has been his weapon of choice tonight.
Weapon of choice because his opponent has not figured out where the knees are coming. High or low, every time he throws them, they're landing. Oh!
Oh, that guillotine is officially tight. Oh, somehow, some way, he got out.
These guys are back and forth, but the submission defense wins this transition.
Right inside his opponent's guard here, DC. You don't want to play around here too long.
No, you got to either have two hands in or two hands out, or guys start to attack triangles. Nice defense.
Oh, the ground and pound strikes continue to rain down. The opponent better move out of harm's way or the referee's going
to
stop this.
He better start to move. And when his opponent starts to posture, he needs to put his feet on the hip, push him away to try to escape this very, very dangerous position.
Good work from the top here by Poirier. Man, another one lands. He's trying to pound his opponent's head through the canvas. Oliveira's trying to get a triangle here. Oh, compromising spot here. Triangle choke is locked in. That looks painful. That's got to be it. Oh, he got out.
Wow, what a great job defensively. Staying aware, staying alert. The moment a little bit of space presented itself, he took it and got himself out of that triangle. Very good defense.
He took it. Charles Oliveira, the winner by submission. Tap out due to a Darce choke. All right, Buff, thank you very much. And there it is yet again, Charles.